Good morning, everybody. Me, Yolanda, with Yolanda Experience Tibet, and
Meg.
And we're here at our excellent campsite. I'm just trying to pan around a little bit so you can see our yaks there. And I'll just show you the scenery a little bit. We were laughing a little earlier about this hotel.
And how far the bathrooms were.
And how far the bathrooms were. And this is a really glorious campsite. This is probably the best campsite we've had. So we just wanted to check in a little bit. What day are we?
We're day three. Well, this is the morning of the fourth day of the trek from Ganden to Samye.
Yeah. So yesterday we did the Shugala. We went Yamado to Shuga over the Shugala Pass, and this is Chitugong or Chitugora or something. Even the Tibetans don't have a solid name for this place. And today we go over the Chitula Pass down to a place called Herders Camp. There's a lot of herders camps around here. I think we're in one right now.
Yeah, that's what I said.
And then the next day, walk out. And then, you know, catch a ride when we get to the road. But since we've been checking in about how we feel, we wanted to check in one more time about how we're doing. So how are you doing?
I'm doing good. I restarted the Diamox again in Lhasa. My only real issue is I'm still having periods of restless kind of sleep in the middle of the night. Still seems to be about that 2 to 3 a.m. And last night just got really chilled. The temperatures were cold enough, I guess. Some of the water in the cook tent froze. We are somewhere above 16,000 feet. I don't know the exact.
16.6 looks like right now.
Yeah. And just, it was a long day yesterday. We know we have a long day ahead today, but physically feeling good otherwise.
Yeah. And when did you stop the Diamox? I stopped it the same day, I think.
But. Yeah. I stopped it when we got to, the day before we got back to Lhasa, I think.
Right. So after the Kailash Kora, and we were definitely coming down all that time. So maybe at 13,000,
yeah,
we stopped it.
Yeah.
And then
we had like a 2-day vacation from the Diamox.
Yes.
And then we restarted it. And I think it helped. I'm not sure why.
We were starting to wonder if the Diamox, it's not supposed to be something that you get, that you start to
develop
tolerance for. But we wondered if we did. We were having that weird experience. I think we did a video about this. We were having that weird experience of super breathlessness at this altitude. Last night, no problem. So 16.5 or 6, I can't remember. I didn't have any of that weird underwater breathing problem.
Yes.
Like feeling like maybe you were having a heart attack or something. Nothing like that. And again, physically, I did the same thing that Meg did. Like, you know, when we were almost at Lhasa, stopped the Diamox, started again about a day before we were heading on this trip, which was started at maybe 13 or something.
Yeah.
And nothing like that. No, what I would call a altitude sickness symptoms. Definitely, and even the breathlessness is better.
Totally, yeah. Maybe we're really just developing an adaptation to the altitude.
Yeah, starting to, right? Like, you know, just kind of walking around. I'm sure we're a little more breathless than we are at sea level, but not like, you know, really feeling it.
Yeah.
And last night, it's always the night. I mean, during the day, you know, I've been feeling okay. But at night, and, you know, it's camping, it's... I don't know what. They were telling us Yeti stories last night. We saw, as we were coming up here, I'm just joking.
And they saw a bear, so I think our minds were a little bit racing last night.
They saw a bear, but our camp cook and the yak herder man, Tencha, they saw something that they said was a bear, but they say some people call that kind of like a Yeti. And we're like, right. Okay, you know, let us know next time. And they said he was heading away from where we're camping. We're like, all right, you know.
Yeah.
But anyway, last night I've been taking some sleep aids when we're at altitude lately. I've been taking some Tylenol PM, which you're not supposed to take any prescription sleep medicine. So I'm staying away from that, but definitely taking some... I'm taking some Tylenol PM. I think that helps sleep at the beginning of the night. There's always this 2 to 3 a.m. thing that goes on, and you like wake up, and you know I have something called restless leg syndrome, which I don't know how common it is. Some people have it, which is exacerbated by exercise. So we definitely had plenty of exercise yesterday. So again, I sound like a pharmacy head, but you know, took some ibuprofen. And just because you need sleep so badly, this is, I think of anything on this trip, it's the sleep deprivation that has been our biggest bugaboo.
Yep. Right? Yeah, it really affects your sort of mental ability to kind of endure everything else. It just kind of, for me, it shuts me down a bit. So those last few days after Mount Kailash were just hard.
Yeah, without being able to sleep.
Yeah.
But here we are at the same altitude that we were then. I had this one episode in the middle of the night, you know, maybe 2 to 3 a.m. Just, you know, I was hot. I had restless, blah, blah, blah. I just did some little steps to take care of each of those things. Took the ibuprofen, took off a layer, and helped the hope to God that the ibuprofen helped the restless leg, which it did. Read for a few minutes, and then I went back to sleep. So it wasn't as gnarly as it can be. But that's how we're doing. This is the highest we're going to be before the end of the trip. We only have some number of days left in our trip, but we'll check in again maybe as we go down. Hope you are doing great. Bye.
Bye.